take a step back. Cause it's only a setback. Himself. What up, homie?
Don't be like that. What's up, Lonnie? Sure. Lonnie Davis, trainer Claude Stan Jr. Tell us what's going on with Claude.
Yo, Claude, he's doing good. He might have a fight next month. March, maybe March 5th. We trying to look at a fight from over there with what's that promotion? With the Duvers.
Main event,
if not with them, I guess we're gonna try to do something with maybe.
So is it gonna be in New York?
Yeah, cause he's coming next week, so I'm gonna train him next week, actually. You know, I'm gonna train him and Big Eugene Russell. So I got a heavyweight
on. Tell us how Eugene Russell's doing.
He's doing good. He fought last week. Yeah, fourth round knockout. So now he's 2-0. And his next fight will be in March also, March 22nd. So I'm going to try to have him and Claude actually fight on the same card on March 22nd. So we're going to see what's going on with that. You know, so that's what we're waiting for right now.
So this is an interesting year in boxing, man, because we got that rematch with Pacquiao and Bradley. Give me your thoughts on that, part two.
Actually, I got Pacquiao winning again.
And you know why you got Pacquiao winning?
Because
you're a southpaw, and he a southpaw, and all y'all southpaws stick together.
Whatever, I'm not biased, man. I'm just going by what I believe.
You're the most biased southpaw ever.
No, that's not right. That's not true. I'm basically going for mentally, not by the heart, but mentally and what I think. I think Pacquiao definitely had him the first fight. He's going to dominate this fight. But Bradley improved a lot, actually, when he fought that Russian. I forget the Russian guy name, but basically, the man Russian guy was banging him up.
Yeah,
but that was a good fight, man. You know, he improved a lot, man, in the last two fights I've seen him with, since he fought Pacquiao.
You had a knockout or a decision?
Decision. I don't think decision. Definitely decision. Cause I think as for now too, I think I think Pacquiao basically he might be a little. I ain't saying shot or anything, but he had a lot of wars. So.
Well, Bradley was saying Pacquiao lost his killer instinct. What does that mean? As a boxer, what does it mean to lose your killer instinct?
Yeah, he said meaning like he's, I guess, his gunshot. He doesn't have that little killer instinct like he had before. Basically, just that little burn. Basically, when he's knocking people out, he hasn't been knocking people out lately. You know, but I think he still has an instinct.
How important to a fighter is that to have the killer instinct?
It's very important because without that, you lost. You lost as a fighter. You don't have anything. You might as well not even fight because you can get hurt. You don't have a killer instinct, but you might as well just stop fighting.
That time we were sparring and I dropped you, did you have a killer instinct?
That shit never happened. And it will never happen. So you need to get that out now. Delete that shit now because I'm a bad man still. At 46, I'll be 47 in a couple of months, I'm still a bad man.
But you're a southpaw though. I mean, you can't be that bad, you know what I'm saying?
Bad meaning good.
Southpaw.
Oh,
flexing. We see the guns through the jacket.
Let me see.